So a lot of people have been asking me how to remove the background from my AI graphic, and more importantly, how to remove that halo, that white halo that you might be seeing around the graphic as well. I'm going to show you how to do it in Photopea. It's going to be totally for free. Let's get into Photopea right now and I'll show you how to do it. All right, so here we are on Photopea. If you haven't been here before, it's pretty much like Photoshop, but the free version of it, and it's free because there's going to be ads on the right-hand side. But anybody can use this. You don't even have to sign in or create an account. You can just go to photopea.com and start using it. What I'm gonna use is an upscaled version of my octopus design that I made for Design with Detour. So first, create your design, but you're gonna have to upscale it first because you wanna make sure that you have the biggest one to remove the background on. You don't wanna remove the background on the 1024 by 1024 one and then upscale it, because then you're still gonna have pixelated edges. So make it as big as you need. I did it 6 times with DGB.LOL, and then I'm gonna take that 6 times, the bigger size, and put it in here. So I have it on my desktop right now, and I'm gonna drag it in here, and that's all you need to do. You see it says octopus 6 times. Drop it in here and it's gonna load. So I wanted to pick this one because this one has a pretty complex background, but it does have this white outline, and that's what a lot of people have been asking, is how do you remove this white outline? Now, there's lots of different ways to do this. I'm gonna show you my way that I do it. It's kind of a little longer process. I'm sure there's shorter ways to do it. You can leave it in the comments if there's a shorter way for you to do it. So the first thing I'm gonna do though is I'm gonna take this magic wand right here. And then I'm gonna click on here on the white and hit delete. And in fact, I'm gonna click on multiple parts and click delete, not the inside, just the outside here. And you can see it's the magic wand is selecting types of color. And because this background, not the white background, but the other background, has so many colors, it's not gonna pick all of them like nicely like the white background is. So if I click this white background, you can see that one erases or gets rid of pretty easy, and so does that one right there. I can even do this white background behind the eyeglasses, and it does a pretty good job there. But for these other ones, we're gonna have to do something a little bit different. And for that, I'm gonna use the eraser tool. So I'm gonna come back here. You can see this one, it says eraser tool. I'm gonna click on it. And I can make the eraser bigger or smaller by hitting the left and right brackets. The right will make it bigger. You see the circle is getting bigger and bigger here. So I'm gonna use that size. And I can, if you can see, it's not erasing, and that's because I have something selected. So hit Command D if it's not working, and that's gonna deselect it, and now I can erase it. There you go. And so I'm gonna do this. You don't have to watch me on this one, but what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna erase everything else with the eraser tool. I'm gonna get really close in here and just kinda go like this. It doesn't take that long. This is kind of a example that has a lot of backgrounds, but usually if it's just a white background and maybe another color, the magic wand will actually get most of it. So I picked a hard one for this example, but you could have a hard one like this too. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna go through all of it and kinda get really close to it like this, and I'll speed this up so we don't have a long video of just me erasing it. But I'll do that right now, and then I'll show you what happens after I've done that. All right, so I'm back, and you can see it looks like I got everything right. But one way to check for sure is to put a background behind it. So I'm gonna move myself here, and you can see this layers panel right here. I'm just gonna add a layer, clicking on that. Now it's layer one. I wanna put it behind my background, so I'll put it there. And then we're gonna fill it. Okay, so I'm gonna use this right here, the select feature. I'm gonna select all of it. That's the whole layer. And then I'm gonna fill it. So I can just do fill by going edit and then fill. You also have a shortcut, F5, but I'm just gonna fill. And then it's gonna ask me what I wanna fill it with. Because I wanna put it on a black t-shirt, I'm gonna fill it with a black. I'm not sure what the foreground or black background is because I haven't been keeping track of my colors. So I'm gonna just do black here. Boom. And then I'm just gonna hit OK. And you can see now I actually didn't get everything. So now I can come up and clean up a little bit more with the eraser tool. So that's what I'm gonna do first. Go back to the eraser tool. Make sure you're on background instead of layer one. And then we're gonna come back in here and kinda clean it up a little bit. So you can see I missed that whole thing here. There's some spots right there and so on. And I can zoom in to make sure I got everything. So here's me zooming in and catching some of these light ones here. Now, when I zoom in, you're also gonna see the halo that people are talking about. And that is this white outline. You see that white outline that goes around the whole thing? We're gonna fix that too. The magic wand doesn't really get close to that. It kinda just gets kinda close and leaves that white outline, and that's because there was that white around it, so it didn't actually clip all of the white, it clipped most of the white. But we're gonna go around here and get as close as we can with the eraser and erase that. And I think we got it. All right, so everything that's left, I'm gonna zoom back in or out. Oh, I didn't put that corner. A lot of times we miss the corners. Yeah, I think we're good. Okay, so next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click on background, I'm gonna right click on it, and I'm gonna convert it to a smart object, and I'll show you why in a minute. But let's just do that first, convert to smart object. Okay, now that it's a smart object, one thing is gonna be different, and it's this, select pixels, right? So we rasterize it as a smart object. Now I can select pixels, and you can see it selected everything that's here, right? And so what we're gonna do is we're gonna contract that so that we're gonna go inside. So you'll see what I mean. So I'm gonna go zoom in so you can see what's happening. So it selected everything, and that everything is outside of that white, but what we wanna do is pull it in. So one thing we can do is go to select and modify and contract. And we're gonna contract by, I like doing 5 pixels, but you can do 7 pixels. Let's do 6 and let's see what happens. I'm gonna hit okay. And you can see it goes in now and not the white. So let me show you. You can see it's in. And so we're gonna, because it's that far in, it shouldn't get any of the white. Now I could have done 5. I think 5 would have been okay. But let me do one more thing, is we're gonna do the inverse of this because we don't wanna knock out the octopus. We wanna knock out everything outside of the octopus. So the next thing we do is hit select again and do inverse, or do this shift command I also works. And now I'm gonna hit backspace or delete. There you go. So you can see the white is gone. And if I hit command D and release it, you can see there is no halo now. It's all nice. So there's some spots because of its AI, you may get some things like this where it is kind of white. What I would do in that case is I would come back with the eraser tool. So come back and look at eraser and take your circle and make sure that it's the right size. And then just, you know, kind of come in here and clean that up if you want to. And that's just because of the way the AI drew it. You may find more things like that if you come in here, maybe this one. Yeah, so this one was kind of white. I would just come in here and just kind of erase it with the eraser tool. Now you could have done that around the whole thing, but that would have took a long time and a really steady hand to do that. So I try to do the that clipping thing first, and then if there's any little ones that needs to be clipped out, you can see right here again, like it didn't get this because it was maybe too far in still. So I'd come in here with my eraser and just kind of clip it out a little bit if you want to. If you don't think it makes that big of a difference, then You don't need to. Now, some of these are really small. Like I'm really zoomed in, so like you may not even see that. But now you can see there's no halo around it. So now when I put it on a black black t-shirt, you don't have that like pixelated white line anymore on it, and it looks great. And this is the right size that you need it. Of course, I would put words on it, maybe export this. Now you don't want to export this layer anymore, but you can see it's really cool. Like it's really nice and sharp. Some parts of the AI in that book could be done better, but the outline of it is really nice. And again, this might be smaller. When I export this as a PNG, you're gonna see that it's actually a pretty big size. See, this is 6144 by 6144 because I six times the 1024 by 1024. So this is definitely gonna be big enough for print on demand, and you won't have those halo edges, and the background is knocked out. So that's how you do it in Photopea. A little bit time consuming. Again, if you know some way that's a lot faster, let me know in the comments. But this is totally free, and I think it does really good for that. And you can see it does some really complex lines too. It's not just straight stuff. The reason why I wanted to get the octopus is you have some twists and turns and stuff, and the background was really hard too. So this can work for anything. So there you go. That's one way to remove the background and keep it a pixel file, a raster file. Now, and get rid of that halo. Now, of course, there's another way to do it. If you vectorize the AI art, then you wouldn't need to remove the halo because everything would be nice straight lines. It shouldn't have that white outline in the vectorized version. I have a video on different places that you could do vectorizing on, so I'll put that right here. And you can see all the different places, all the different apps that can do that. Thanks again for watching. Hopefully this was really helpful for you. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.